Hello viewer, a warm welcome to Elimu TV, where you exclusively watch and learn. Today we're going to learn about mathematics, the first topic in Form 1, which is natural numbers. So for any feedback, any question you'd love to ask us, our SMS number is 22518. You can also write to us, our Facebook page is Elimu TV, and our Twitter handle is @Elimu_KE. I am your teacher, Madam Chrissy Locott. I'll be taking you through this lesson. So first of all, before we start our lesson, most of us have a very negative mindset about mathematics. From the time maybe you just switched and you found out that it's maths, some of you have frowning faces, some of you are just not feeling well. Why? Because you have that mindset that mathematics is hard. But in real sense, mathematics is not hard. So for us to start our lesson, I just want to share with you something. There's a famous quote that goes by this: just because something is difficult, it does not mean that you should not try. It simply means you should try harder. So if you have the mindset that math is hard, it's not supposed to mean that you're not supposed to try it. It means put more effort, and that is what we're going to do today. So welcome to this lesson, feel free and let us have fun. So our first topic today, subtopic, we're going to deal with natural numbers. So before anything, we're going to define some of the difficult or some words that we may have learned about, but we do not know what they mean. For example, so we're going to learn about, so this is just a preview of what we're going to learn today. First, we're going to define what are natural numbers and give some of the examples. We're also going to look at what are digits. We use them every day in mathematics. We're going to look at the place value today in our lesson. Also, we're going to look at the value or what we call the total value. Then we're also going to know how to write numbers in an expanded form. And also, we're going to know how to read numbers in either symbols or in words. So the first thing, let us define what are natural numbers. They are also called the counting numbers. So what are these? So these are all whole numbers that do not have any negative sign in them. For example, from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and you continue. As long as there's no negative value in it. So those are what you call the natural or the counting numbers, because you can use them in counting. Then we go to digits, the digits that we have in mathematics. So this is any number from 0 to 9. So from 0 up to 9, these are what we call the digits. We have the 10 digits in our numbers. Then lastly, we have what we call whole numbers. So whole number is any number that is from 0 going onward. It should not be a fraction or it should not be a decimal. For example, 1, 2, 3. If I have something like 1 over 4, this one is not a whole number. If I have 0.25, this one is not a whole number. So a whole number will be any number that is not either a fraction or it's not a decimal. So first we're going to look at how to count the digits that we have in any number. For example, if I have a number like 4, 7, 8, 3, 4, 1. That is the first example. How many digits make this number? So you're going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So these are 6 digits that make this number that we have here. Then another example, if we have something like 8, 7, 6, 9, 4, 3, 1. So how many digits are making this number? So you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So these are 7 digits that make our number. Another example, if I have 0, 0, 1, 6, 8, 9. 0 is also a digit. So if you are counting it, you're going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So these are 6 digits that are making a specific number. Another example, if you were to count a billion has how many digits? So from a million you go to a billion. So how many digits does a billion have? So if you are to count, you start 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So a billion is made up of 10 digits. 10 digits. So move on. The next thing you're going to look at today is the place value of a number. So the place value. So what exactly is a place value of a number? So a place value of a number is the number, is the position in which the number appears in. The position in which the number appears in any given number. So that specific digit where it's appearing, that is the place value. For example, if I have a number like 4, 3, 2, 1. So 3, where does it appear in my number? So this 3 here, that is the position. So this is the position where it appears. So the position is what we refer to as a place value. The position in which a specific digit appears in a number. So let us look at the whole table of place value. So from the place value, we normally start with the ones. So here we have the ones. Then we go to the tens. We go to the hundreds. Then we go to the thousands. Next we move to the ten of thousands. From tens of thousands, we go to hundred of thousands. Then we move to millions. We can still move to tens of millions. Then we can have hundreds of millions. So if I was to have a number like 8, 4, 3, 6, 0, 5, 1. And you're supposed to find out the place value of each of the following number. So we'll start by placing the ones here. So we have 1, 5, 0, 6, 3, 4, 8. So we're looking at the place value. In the number 1, so 1 it appears as the ones. Then from 1s you go to 10s. So 5 appears under the 5s. Then 0 is under the column of 100s. Then you move to 6, which falls on 1000s. So there is the column. Then you move to 3, which falls under 10s of 1000s. Then you move to 4, that falls under 100s of 1000s. And finally, you move to 8, which goes in the column of million. So these are specific place value of the different digits that appear in our whole number, which is 8,436,051. So let us look at more example of finding the place values of numbers. So if I have 234, so how do I place the values? So the first one is the 4s. The 4 appears under 10s. From the 10s you move to the 4 goes from, it's under 1s. Then the 3 is under 10s. And 2 is under 100s. So that is the place value. You always have to start from the further end. So this one is 1s, you move to the 10s, then you move to 100s. So let us look at more examples. So what is the place value of 4 in the following number? What is the place value of 4 in, so these are the numbers here. We have 3, 4, 2, 1. So we're looking at the place value of 4 only. Then our second example, we have 4, 6, 3, 2, 1, 1, 0. We're looking at the place value of 4 here. And finally, we have 2, 3, 1, 4. Looking at the place value of 4. So we start. This is 1s, 10s, 100. So here the place value is 100s. Remember to add the S. Then here we move from 1s, 10s, 100s, 1000, 10 of 1000, 100 of 1000. Then finally we move to millions. And when you're writing the place value, remember the final S there. Then in our final example, 4, the place value of 4 would fall under 1s. So with that, we have done the place value. So there's something different we call the total place value, or we call it the total value of a number. So how do we get the total value of a number? That is, we have to first know the place value of the specific digit in the number. So the total value is the number, you find it by taking the specific digit, then you multiply it by the place value. You take the digit, then you multiply it by the place value. So you can have an example. For example, if we have 4, 3, 2, 1. So this is 4,321. We want to find the place, the total value of 3. So we're going to take 3 is the specific digit. So it is 3. We multiply it by the place value. What is the place value of 3 in our number? So this is ones, tens, hundreds. So this one will be times 100. So our total value for this digit 3 is going to be 300. If you are to find the place value, no, the total value of 4, so 4 falls under 1000. So the specific digit here is 4. We multiply it by the place value, which is 1, 2, this is ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. So times 1000. So we get our total value to be 4000 in this specific example. So that is the difference between the place value and a total value. So we can just have another example to explain. So if you want to have our table here, we have our digit in one column, then we have the place value. So this is our digit, this is our place value, then this is our total value. So if I have a number like 4, 6, 1, 2. So I will write the digit from the biggest, 4, 6, 1, 2. So in 4, 4 is under 1000. So the place value of 4 is thousands. The place value of 6 in our value here in our number is hundreds. The place value of 1 here is tens. And the place value of 2 here is ones. So how do I get my total value? We say you take the specific digit, you multiply it by the place value. So in this case, you're going to have 4 times 1000. We can create another column. So here it's 4000. 6 multiplied by 100, you get 600. 1 multiplied by the place value, which is 10th, you get 10 here. And finally, 2 multiplied by 1, you get 2 here. So when you add up this value, you're going to go back to what you had. So here I'm going to have 2. In this column, I'll have 1. In the hundreds, I'll have 6. And in the thousands, I'm going to have 4. So this is how you calculate the total value. So we're going to look at another area of writing number in expanded forms. So we're writing in expanded form. If I have a number like 56,809. So you are told to write this number in an expanded form. An expanded form means that you're going to write this number in terms of their total value. So in this case, this one comes under ones, this is tens, this is hundreds, this is thousands, and this is 10, 10 of thousands.
So write it in an expanded form in terms of the total value. So with the first one, I will start 5 times its value, the places, so it is 10 times 10,000, plus 6 is the digit, times the place value, it falls under 1,000, so times 1,000. Move to the next number, which is 8 times 100. And finally, you move to the 0, so it is plus 0 times 10. And finally, you move to 9 times 1. And we leave our answer in that form. So we have written the original number as an expanded value. If you add down, if you break down this number, it's supposed to give you the same number. So writing a number in an expanded form, that is the procedure of which we can use to write a number in an expanded form. So we move to the next stage, in which you are going to learn how to write. Going to learn how to write in words. Writing numbers in words. So, for example, if we have a value like 9,321. Now, writing it using word, you're supposed to start with the first number here. So this one is 9,321. So this one is our number, then we are going to write it using words. Then another example, let's look at another example. We have 4, 6, 3. So we always start from the bigger number. So in our case, the bigger number here is the million. So we'll go 4,000,000. Remember to put your comma, 632. Our comma, 411. So we are using the words to write our number. Then the final example, if we have a number like 6009, how exactly are we going to write this? So this does the same. We start with the bigger number, which is 6,000. So we have 6,000. So in between, you don't have any number, so we're not going to write here zeros. So we'll say 6,009. So that is how we write our number. So, and the reverse is now how we're going to learn how to write the words and to become the numbers. If you are given now the words and you turn them into the numbers. So now we learn. So for example, I have the first example, example one, I have 6,000,000 100 and 20. So we're going to write each of the words, each of the following numbers in its own set. So for example, we now start with 6 million. So write 6 million in its own column. So this is 6 million. Then from million, now we move to the next, 121,000. So we have 121,000. Then we move to 615. So we have 615. So when we add all this up, is going what is going to give us our final answer. So here is 5161. Remember our comma, 21, and finally our 6. That's how you write your number. So for our assignment today, so for our assignment, question one, you write the place value. Of 4 in the following number. So the first one we have 2, 3, 4, 6. So find the place value of 4 in the following number. So that has been our lesson for today, and thank you for watching Elimu TV. So I'm going to leave you with this. Mary's father had 3 sons. Mary's father had 3 daughters. The first daughter was called Susan, and the other one was called Evelyn. So what is the name of the third daughter? So in mathematics, you don't have to think so hard. Thanks much. See you in the next lesson. Thank you.